Hello students, today we are going to learn lesson number 2, Inside Internet. Before starting this chapter, I explain you the small talk topic, that is Internet. We already study in previous standard, but today we will revise little bit. First, the first word comes here, network. Now, what is network? In simple way, if I say network is the interconnection of different computers. Network is the interconnection of different computers. Can also say network. Network is a group of computers connected with each other. Look at this picture. There are three users. The three users computers are connected with internet. So this is the topic of networks. We had only one computer lab in our school till now. This year we will have two more such labs, and all of them will be interconnected. We can also access the internet on any computer in any lab. The computers in the office and library of the school will also be on this network. At our school library and at our school office, the computers are connected with one common network. So now move to topic network. A computer network is a system of linkage between two or more computers or electronic devices connected together so that they can exchange data. The short definition of network: a network is the interconnection of different computers. Can also say network is a group of computers connected with each other. The another one definition is network is a group of computers connected with each other. Okay. We can share printer as well as if one printer has a problem, we can print using one in any of the other lab. Just example, lab 4 or 5 printers are available. So in one printer there has a problem, so we can print using one in any of the other lab. Now the next topic, the network has a 4 types of network: LAN, WAN and MAN. The first point, LAN. The full form of LAN is local area network. We would like to understand the connection and hardware used to create such a network. How are the computers and device connected in your lab? In our lab, the computers are connected using network cables. One side of the cable is connected to a network port on the computer and the other to a box with several ports. Look at the first picture. This is a network cable, and second picture is this is a network port. In your lab, you all view this cable and you all see these network ports. Inside your CPU box, these ports are available. And this network cable are attached into this port, network ports. The box is called a network switch or hub. It is used to interconnect computers in a small area and create a network. So such a network is called a LAN. LAN means local area network. Now we move to another topic, LAN. A local area network interconnects computers in a limited area such as home, school, computer lab, etc. LAN network are interconnect computer in limited area. Just example, at your home only. in school only, your lab only. So this is this is the connection of LAN. Just example, you open your LAN connection, you open your Wi-Fi connection at your school. So it is not open because the connection is your home. That's the reason it is not connected in your school. But we access our school Wi-Fi, LAN connection Wi-Fi, so it is accessible. Then cables or low power radio are used for making a connection in a LAN. Suppose I want to access a file on, does the switch relay the data between our computer? A computer network allows computer to share file and application. User can communicate with each other and share a device. A computer network allows two computers to share your file and application. With the use of LAN connection, you can share your files and application to one PC to another PC, and you can communicate with each other and share your devices. Any computer that needs to be connected to the network has a network interface card. It means NIC. The full form of NIC, it means network interface card, which is usually built into the motherboard. Your NIC is present into the motherboard. Now, yes. Suppose some data has to be sent from your computer to your friend computer. The computer A split the data into small chunks. So it is called packets. Each packet also has some extra information, which is called header. All packets has some extra information, so which is called header. The address of the sender A and receiver B are put in the header. Then the computer send the packets to the switch. Look at this figure. The switch has an inbuilt software that reads the header of each packet, determine the port at which that receive is connected, and forward the packets to the corresponding cable. Such type of communication in which small units of data are routed through a network based on the destination address contained within each packet is called a packet switched. What is the definition of packet switching? Based on the destination address contained within each packet, it's called a packet switching. The packet is similar to a letter enclosed in an envelope. The envelope has the address of the sender and receiver. Look at the picture 3, figure 3A. Here, this is a envelope. The envelope has the address of the sender and receiver. Why is the message divided into so many packets? Why is it not sent as a single packet? Breaking the message down into packets allow the same cables to be shared among many users in the network. As a result, the capacity of the network to accommodate simultaneously user is increased. Are the packets numbered? After all the packets are received by the destination computer, they get complete into a complete message. Yes, the packets are numbered. These are called a sequence numbers. The packet also has information about the total length of the message. The packet save the information about the total length of the message. Look at this picture. The picture is packet switching in a data network. First, you can see the computer. There are a different router are connected to each other. Then the server PC are also connected to router and the computer. So, many paths may be used for a single communication as individual packets are routed to a destination. Prior to the transmission, each communication is broken into packets which are address and number. During peak period, communication may be delayed but not denied. In this picture, the one communication is broken into the packets which are address and number. During peak period, communication may be delayed but not denied. The communication denied. No fixed path is established. Packets are routed according to the best path available at the time. At the destination, packets may be reassembled into order according to their sequence number. All the packets are come into the sequence number. Now, next point, package. A packet is format unit of data. A packet consists of two kinds of data. One is control information, it means header, and another one is user data. It is also known as payload. The header provides the information the networks need to deliver the user data. For example, source and destination address error detection code like checksum and sequencing information. Typically, control information is found in a package header and trailers with payload data in between. Packet switching. The next topic is packet switching. A message from one computer on the internet to another gets divided into packets before being sent. It means one computer on the internet gets divided into packets before being sent. Before sending the message, the one computer gets divided into packets. Each packet is transmitted individually and can even follow different routes to the destination. Once all the packets forming a message arrive at the destination, they are recompiled into the original message. All the messages arrive at the destination and they are recompiled into the original message. It means they all are come into the original message. Such type of communication in which small units of data, it means packets, are routed through a network. Based on the destination address contained within each packet, so it is called packet switching. The small definition of packet switching contained within each packet, it is called a packet switching. Now, move to the protocol. TCP and IP. The full form of TCP, it means Transmission Control Protocol, and the full form of IP, it means Internet Protocol. It is a set of rules used to interconnect computers and communicate data on the internet. They both are used to transmit a data and communicate data on the internet. The next, TCP/IP specify how packets are transmitted based on IP address and then route to and receive at the correct destination. The work of TCP/IP is transmit the packets through the IP addresses and the route to and receive at the correct destination. The network address. A network address serves as a unique identifier for a computer on a network. When set up correctly, computers can determine the addresses of other computers on the network and use this address to send a message to each other. The work of network address is send the message is addressed to each other network. Then the hub. A hub is a networking device that provides a common connection point for multiple computers on a network. The work of hub is provide a common connection point to multiple computers. Then next, switch. A switch is a networking device that filters and forwards data packets between LAN segments. The work of switch is filter and forward data packets between LAN segments. Now move to the next point, VLAN. VLAN means wireless LAN. The full form of LAN is local area network. I have seen laptops connecting to the network without a cable. You all are see in your laptop without network cable. You all are connecting your laptop. So with the use of Wi-Fi, it is called a wireless LAN and it is also called a Wi-Fi. In some place like airports, office, cable are not required at all. Anyone with a laptop, smartphone or a tablet can access the internet. If you have a mobile phone, then with the use of your phone, you can start your Wi-Fi at suppose, just example, you are standing on the airport. If you want to open the airport network connection, first what we do, for we can start our phone Wi-Fi and we can attempt to airport Wi-Fi and we can start. So this is are called a wireless connection. Look at this picture. The computer, wireless tower, server, printer, they all are connected with switch and hub. Radio signals are used to connect a computer to the network. A wireless antenna is built into the laptops. You look at the wireless antenna are built into the laptops to send and receive data. Similarly, the switch also has an antenna for transmitting and receiving data wirelessly. The work of switch is receive and transmitting data wirelessly. And it is called a VLAN, means wireless local area network. VLAN, a LAN that use radio signals to connect computer is called a VLAN. VLAN means the LAN that is use radio signals. So it is called a VLAN, means wireless local area network. The one type of commonly used radio signal is Wi-Fi. The another name is VLAN, it means Wi-Fi. In a VLAN, a wireless switch with one or two antennas, usually sticking out from the back of the switch, is used for sending and receiving data to and from the computer. The use of switch is sending and receiving data to from the computer. The range of wireless connection is approximately 50 meters. Computers and other devices capable of sending and receiving data wirelessly can become a part of a VLAN when they are within a range. We know that we can access websites like Google and Amazon from any country. How does a computer in one country connect to one in another country? Computers across long distance are usually connected with optical fiber cables, satellite radio links or microwave radio links. Such as a network is called a VLAN. WAN means wide area network. The internet is an example of WAN. Two or more LAN can also be a part of WAN. It means wide area network. See this figure number 6. Here the LAN connection and VLAN are connected with, first of all, look at this first picture. WAN Mumbai office, all the clients are connected with wire switches. Then the second one is the office of Delhi. This is the connection of LAN. All the client are connected with switch and hub. And both connection are connected with satellite. So WAN it means a wide area network. A network which is geographically spread over large area with links between computers is called a WAN. It means wide area network. The long distance connection are established using technology such as a optical fiber cable, satellite radio links and microwave radio links. The WAN connection network that make up a wide area network be located through a country or even around the world. For example, internet and ATM facility. When a single company owns and controls a wide area network, it is often called as a enterprise network. Is there a switch between the LANs or computers communicating across long distance? Yes, it is a special type of switch that has more function than a LAN switch. It is called a router. It has a software to send and receive packets correctly across WAN. Routers communicate with each other to ensure that your packets are delivered to the correct destination across the WAN internet. Now move to the next topic, router. A router is a network device that connects to more network. A common use is to join a home or business network. A common use of router is join the business network and home network. It will typically have the internet cable plugged into it, as well as cable to computer or switch on LAN. Some router are also a wireless capable. What are the different method of connecting to the internet? You must have used at least one method. At home, we connected to computer using a dongle with USB connector. We all are using a dongle. So this is the part of connecting to network with the use of dongle. Where do you get this dongle from? We have to buy it from the internet service provider. Right, the dongle is a part of USB device that can be plugged into computer for accessing the internet. If you want to access your internet with the use of dongle, so first step, what we do, first of all, we can put our dongle into our computer. Then after we start to install a dongle, and then after we start to connect the internet. It has an inbuilt wireless that connects to the ISP. The full form of ISP is Internet Service Provider, similar to mobile phone. On a mobile phone, we can access the internet by enabling some settings. An internet service provider is an organization that provides access to the internet. ISP is an organization that provides access to the internet. I have seen some connection that use telephone line. At your home, maybe all connection are with the use of telephone line. So a device is called a modem. Is connected to the computers in such a connection. Right. Similar to peripheral devices, a modem converts the data and instruction enter using the device into a pattern of electrical signals. These signals correspond to a binary code that can be processed by a digital computer. Do you know the meaning of binary codes? The computer reads the binary language 0 and 1. So that is a binary code that can be processed by a digital computer. Look at this picture. This is your modem. Now, internet access single user and multi user. User internet connection DSL, digital subscriber line modem. It is device used to connect a computer or router to the internet through a telephone circuit. In the DSL connect modem, the router or connector and the internet comes through a telephone circuit. Then another modem is broadband modem. Use a DSL or a cable internet service to connect to the internet. Here the DLS line connect to your phone jack and the USB line or Ethernet connects to your computer. DSL line are connected with your phone and the USB line or Ethernet connect to your computer. It means the broadband modem are connected with your phone and your computers. Mobile broadband. This is a mobile broadband. Use a wireless internet card such as a USB dongle to connect to the internet. This dongle can be used whenever the ISP provides a coverage by plugging it into the USB port on a network PC or netbook PC or laptop. If you want to connect a US mobile, first of all you can put your devices, you can put your dongle into your PC and then after you can start mobile broadband connection. Then after next, portable internet devices, smartphone, tablets, etc. use a variety of wireless technology. The first technology is 2G network, 3G, now Wi-Fi and WiMAX to connect to the internet. Now, move to next topic, multi-user interconnection. It means multi-user interconnection. That means the Wi-Fi at home. Just example I am giving you. At your home, they have one router. Then your family member are connected with one router. So it is the meaning of multi-user interconnection. This is an extension of single user access by connecting Wi-Fi access switch to broadband modem. Fiber to the home broadband, FTTH. The full form of FTTH means fiber to the home broadband. It uses fiber optical cables to connect to the internet. Such a optics based system can deliver digital information very efficiently. A peripheral device is an external object that provides input and output for the computers, for example keyboard, monitor, etc. Next lecture we are discuss the